I was killed by the court of public opinion and sent to the shadow realm of disgraced YouTubers for my crimes against the internet. You're probably thinking that this is a natural consequence of my ego growing too big, but I can assure you that I'm not in the wrong. My detractors are the problem. I know I sent my fans to attack an artist by the name of Ludenwaff for drawing fan art of me in a one-piece swimsuit, but in my defense, that piece of fan art was disgusting. And I had expressed numerous times that I don't like my character being drawn that way. But then I turned around and featured a drawing of my pyramid character in a bikini in one of my videos. This is totally not a double standard. I prefer to call it rules for thee and not for me. Remember when I discussed Wonderstruck's mental health without his consent? Well, I did the same thing to Tipster a few years earlier on a live stream, but he was totally okay with it and thought it was funny, and I was part of a group that made these kinds of jokes all the time, so the anything goes approach was totally fine in my book. But don't you dare make a fat joke about somebody. Tommy C had to learn this lesson the hard way when I deleted all of the videos that featured me on his channel because he made a fat joke. He didn't make a fat joke about me, he made a fat joke about someone on his team named Rico, so I decided to retaliate. You're probably thinking that this was extremely hypocritical and underhanded, but it was just my way of showing appreciation to someone that I once considered a friend. And besides, it was his fault that he gave me administrator access to his channel. When Nicholas DiOrio made a video mocking me, I lied to an artist and claimed Nick used their artwork without their permission in order to get the video taken down, and wouldn't you know it, that video disappeared faster than Thanos snapping his fingers. Please don't look into the fact that I threatened my ex-boyfriend Azothan over the phone after we broke up. He wasn't good enough for me anyways. He was mediocre and a burden, and I know this because he told me that when he thought about killing himself. Blair, you're being too mean! How could you say that about someone you once claimed to love? I needed to put him in his place and remind him that he wasn't good enough for the Golden Queen. My previous actions were not enough for the court of public opinion to take action, but when I was exposed for abusing and harassing my former friends and colleagues, they finally had enough and decided I needed to be put in timeout with all of the other bad YouTubers. And all of it started because I went after an actual lawyer on Twitter over an editing plugin. But what they didn't know is that I brought myself back to life with the power of up, up, down, down, left, right, BA, start. I now had 30 extra lives to ruin my reputation even further, which is why I used my second chance to do whatever I needed to do in order to eliminate my detractors. It's time for the world to hear me roar once again. Allow me to reintroduce myself. My name is Blair. Hello everyone, and welcome to the weekly meeting for the Court of Public Opinion. So what's on the agenda for tonight, Denise? We received word earlier today that a YouTuber by the name of Illuminati squashed a beef with another YouTuber by the name of Cruel World Happy Mind. I've never heard of these two before. Who are they and why were they beefing? Madison reached out to Blair privately after somebody claimed that Blair copied her video about Tyra Banks' MLM. Blair went on a podcast and made up this ridiculous story that Madison had accused her of copying her video and that she was demanding credit. Madison didn't do any of those things and only pointed out that their videos were somewhat similar. So you're telling me that this whole thing was caused by a misunderstanding? That's exactly what I'm saying. It's important to mention that Madison went out of her way to be friendly and respectful to her. She continued to reach out to her privately to try and squash this beef, but Blair never responded to her messages, which left her with no choice but to make a video defending herself. And then Blair tweeted that she was going to make a debunking stream, which made no sense because there was nothing to debunk, and then bam, all of a sudden they squashed the beef. Do you have any idea why she did this? We believe that Blair did this out of jealousy. Her and Madison are a part of the anti-MLM movement here on YouTube. Blair claimed that she had no idea that there was an anti-MLM community. We believe that this is a lie because in order to make videos in any genre, you have to be aware that a community already exists around it. Blair has 751,000 subscribers, while Madison has 68,000. There is no doubt in our mind that Blair used the power and influence that comes from having a larger channel in order to try and get rid of someone she saw as competition. Starting a feud with a smaller channel over something this petty wouldn't make sense unless that was the reason. Is there anything else about this Illuminati person that I need to know about? She used to play a character called Sarah J. Warren for a comedic news show created by the YouTuber Tommy C. That relationship went sour when he made a fat joke about someone on his team named Rico. She decided to retaliate by deleting every video that featured her off his channel. This was baffling to us because she had no problem mocking tipsters' mental health on a live stream.
Engaging with you all, I also feel like I'm putting a lot of pressure on myself to deliver. For example, I have had a literal breakdown last night when I ran into tech issues while trying to stream. As fun as making videos is, all this pressure to do my best only results contributes to even more stress. Tonight, I had the worst anxiety attack of my life. I didn't get much sleep last night due to staying up all night editing videos and further resolving the previously mentioned tech issues. I worked overtime at my daily job today, and work got so busy that I didn't get a chance to take lunch. During the drive home, I began to hyperventilate to the point that I had to pull over and get out of my car to breath. After a few minutes, I thought it was okay, so I got back into the car and proceeded to drive home. This process repeated two more times during the course of the entire drive home. As much as I love making videos, I feel like I am seriously putting too much pressure on myself to give you all my best. I feel like I am putting too much pressure on myself to put out daily content, and I feel like all this pressure, in addition to the stress of my life, is starting to have negative impact.
To be clear, Tipster was okay with this and he even thought it was funny, but we found it to be hypocritical because in her eyes, making a fat joke about someone is not okay, but joking about someone's mental health is totally fine. To say that this is a double standard would be an understatement. We also found out that Blair got a video that Nicholas DiOrio made about her removed from YouTube by lying to an artist and telling them that Nick had used their artwork in his thumbnail without their permission. But after Nick and the artist in question had a discussion, the video went back up after Nick agreed to use a different image for his video thumbnail. Blair tried to get the video taken back down by lying to another artist, but thankfully it didn't work because that particular artist didn't care. I'm gonna be honest with you guys, everything you just told me is petty, dime a dozen YouTube drama that everyone is going to forget about in a week. Kevin, if we don't nip this in the bud while we have the chance and hold Blair accountable for her actions, she could do something even worse in the future and bring this entire platform into disrepute. I'm not saying that what she's doing is right. As a matter of fact, it makes her look like an asshole. But being an asshole on the internet is not a crime. If that were the case, a dose of Buckley would have been sentenced to life in the Shadow Realm for his Cory Monteith video. What you've shown me is not a good enough reason to light the pitchforks and turn the entire internet against her. With all due respect, Mr. Blackstock, if the shit hits the fan in 2 years from now and we decide to turn against Blair, we will be accused of being clout chasers that are only interested in getting views and appeasing the algorithm. We are not mind readers. We have no way of foreseeing what will happen in the future, and we certainly have no way of knowing whether or not Blair will turn out to be a terrible person, but my point still stands. We have no reason to make a big deal about Illuminati unless she does something totally egregious. We are moving on from this petty nonsense, and that's final. Do I make myself clear? Yes, Mr. Blackstock. I'm so happy that we're finally having this conversation. I was hoping you would eventually respond to my DM so we could squash this beef once and for all. So you're the one that demanded credit and accused me of copying your video. That's not true. This whole thing is a huge misunderstanding. One of my friends, Kimberlea, told me that you copied my video on Tyra Beauty, so I watched your video and quickly came to the conclusion that you didn't copy me, which is why I reached out to you privately. I also want to make it abundantly clear that I did not demand credit. But you said our videos sounded similar, which, correct me if I'm wrong, sounds a lot like an accusation, Madison. I didn't mean for it to be an accusation, I was merely making an observation, and on top of that, I adore you, you make fantastic content, and I've always looked up to you, so when you decided to go on a podcast and lie about what I messaged you about for everyone on the internet to hear, I was really hurt by that. So why did you go public by making a video about our little disagreement? Because when I reached out to you, privately, you didn't respond to any of my messages, so I assumed that you were busy, so I moved on and forgot about it. But when I was being harassed relentlessly because of the lies you told, I had no choice but to defend myself. You took what I said completely out of context to portray yourself as the victim of a false accusation. Your little video made me look petty and vindictive, and I can't have people publicly thinking that I'm some kind of monster that bullied and harassed a smaller channel over something as petty as a Tyra Banks MLM video. Why else do you think I tweeted about doing debunking streams? There was nothing to debunk, which is why I frantically contacted you in order to facilitate this conversation. That tweet was all smoke and mirrors, which is why I'm making you a deal. If you delete your video on me, then I won't proceed with my debunking stream and we can pretend that this silly little feud never happened. Now be a good little girl and do the right thing, Madison. Don't make me destroy you. If this is what it takes to squash this beef, then I'm all for it. I just got pregnant with my first child and my doctor told me to avoid any kind of stress. This entire situation has stressed me out beyond belief. So if deleting this video will no longer make me public enemy number one on planet Blair, then I'll do whatever you want. What exactly did you have in mind for this peace offering?
One eternity later.
Just got off the phone after a 3-hour-long convo with Cruel World Happy Mind, and I'm very happy that we were able to finally talk and resolve our issues privately. Ultimately, there was a series of misunderstandings from both sides. We have worked those out to stop the escalation of any drama. She will be removing her part about me in a video she recently did. In return, I will not do the planned livestream on her. We were able to not only work out our problems, but come to a common understanding and even have a great convo at the end about our research philosophy and interpretations on many parts of MLMs, our personal lives, etc. We both want the drama between it to end. There is no ill will here, and we are moving on. I appreciate that we are both able to move on, and maybe once the restrictions in Colorado lighten up, we can hang out one day too, Madison. I appreciated the chat. We needed to have it. And I'm happy that we are on the same page on a vast majority of things. Thank you for coming into the convo level-headed with me so we could knock this out and move on. I really appreciate you having a respectful conversation with me and hearing me out. I'm really glad we were able to do that and move forward understanding one another better. Did I do good, Blair? Did I do good, Blair? Did I... I'm glad you could make it here today, Oz. Please have a seat. I rushed over here when you said you needed to talk to me about something important. Remember when I helped you with your finances because I saddled you with an enormous amount of debt? How could I forget? Between the multi-million dollar house you threatened to break up with me over, Wonderstruck's car, and a ton of other expenses, my finances have been sinking faster than the Titanic, which is why I asked you for help, because couples are supposed to help each other out with these kinds of things. The money I used to help you with your finances was company money, and when I told Evan about it, he informed me that I had committed embezzlement. If I get busted by the IRS for this, I will be facing some pretty serious jail time. My mom went to jail when I was 11 for committing embezzlement, so the mere thought of another person that I love going to jail for that same crime eats me up inside. I am so sorry that I put you in that position. You don't have to worry about me, because I have come up with a solution to all of our problems. I have restructured that debt into a loan that you'll pay back to me on a monthly basis, and you can also come and work for me as another way of paying off the debt. Doing it this way will ensure that I get the money that you owe me, and that I'm not breaking the law. If you love me as much as you say you do, then you'll sign on the dotted line. The future of our relationship depends on it. You know I love you with all of my heart, Blair. So if this is what I have to do in order to save our relationship, then I will take one for the team.
Congratulations, you played yourself.
I'm so glad we sorted this out, because I've been stressing heavily about my finances recently. Thank you for being so understanding about my predicament. You're the best girlfriend a guy could ever ask for. I'll see you tonight, honey. Enjoy the rest of your day, Mr. Christie. Does he know what he just signed? He has absolutely no idea. By the time Santa makes his yearly trip around the world, my soon-to-be ex-boyfriend will know what it's actually like to be homeless. Doobie Schmertz Evil Incorporated! We've just been informed that there is a pedophile in your Discord server. How in the living hell did that happen? The individual in question was engaging in an inappropriate conversation with a 15-year-old, and then he offered to send dick pics to him. We were informed of this by somebody named CB2, who was a very small YouTube commentary channel. Are you serious? That annoying, drama-obsessed stalker is the one behind this? I fucking hate that guy. I bet he only blew the whistle because he wanted to purposely start drama and dance on my grave. I want him banned from this server this instant. CB2 is not the issue here. There is a pedophile in this server, and we have to deal with it. Even if CB2 intentionally infiltrated the server to start drama, it wouldn't change the fact that there is a pedophile in the server. I am going to get him legally served for harassment, and I have already sent a private investigator to teach this kid not to mess with the Golden Queen. Hopefully, he'll learn his lesson about making multiple videos about someone else's downfall. You called out the click for having a pedophile in his server. It would be very hypocritical for you to not ban the individual responsible for trying to send a dick pic to a 15-year-old when you made such a big stink about how awful of a person the click was for not banning a pedophile from his server when he was asleep. You know how much I hate kids, Grace. I'm one of those leave our kids alone types. Calling out the click was nothing more than a benefit. Banning CB2 would be a benefit in terms of getting rid of a drama-obsessed leech. Not banning the pedophile in question would not be a benefit, because I wouldn't be able to come out on top and portray myself as the good guy. Don't you get it? Grifters don't have any sort of conviction. We, in good conscience, cannot allow this to happen. You're more worried about drama than the fact that there is a pedophile in your Discord server. You have to open your eyes and realize that this isn't drama. This is dangerous, and we have a responsibility to put a stop to it before he does the same thing to somebody else. This is a child we're talking about, and that's more important than your dislike of a smaller channel. I love it when you call me Pyramid, Mom. Ban CB2 from this server. Anyone that mentions drama will be banned. Blair, 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 can't you see? Sometimes your words just hypnotize us. We'll do whatever you say because we're afraid to lose our jobs. I think we may be witnessing the end of Illuminati as we know it. Surely there's something we can do to reverse this horrible slide. The court of public opinion should have moved on from this by now. We all know that the internet has a very short attention span when it comes to these kinds of things. There's nothing we can do about this, Grace. The views on all the recent videos have been terrible, and they've all been flooded with hate comments about how much they hate Blair and how much she sucks, and it's been like this for months. Not even Colleen Ballinger pulling out the ukulele to give the worst apology in YouTube history, and her performing in green face paint that everyone thought was blackface was enough to get the heat off of her. We are deeply and truly fucked. So you're basically telling me that we won't have jobs after all of this is said and done? Unless a miracle miraculously falls from the sky that makes her the least hated person on the internet, then we'll be getting pink slips when she collides with a badnik and loses all of her golden rins. And then when she runs into another badnik, the channel will die completely. At least the backlog of videos we built up are being uploaded without any problems. Yeah, about that.
Quote, the Kenya National Commission on Human Rights said the move was inappropriate and will traumatize the survivors at a time when they most desperately require empathy. At the same time, I can understand why authorities on the matter would be so conflicted. Like, what exactly should happen to these parents? Yes, they were brainwashed and traumatized, but some of them also killed their own children. How much empathy should be shown? It's a tragedy, and these parents and adults need to be treated. They do need help. But they also need consequences for the horrific acts they committed. I am slightly curious as to how you feel about this. Please feel free to let me know, because I just don't think I've ever encountered such a specific situation before. With Jonestown and other cults that force members to take their own lives, it tends to happen all at once, just everyone at the same time. While the process of recruiting someone and brainwashing can be slow, the actual death typically isn't. There's really no easy way of handling this. That's all I can say with certainty. I do hope that Pastor McKenzie dies in prison, suffers somehow, just lives a miserable rest of his mortal life. At least that's how I feel about it. But while prison is an obvious consequence, there has been a ripple effect from this. See, religion is huge in Kenya. Only less than 3% of Kenyans are not religious whatsoever.
Where's the audio for the rest of this video? The few remaining editors we had left all jumped ship. One of them told me that their reputation would be severely damaged if they continued to work with Blair, and they no longer want to be associated with a sinking ship. So Blair had no choice but to edit the video herself, and she forgot to fix the lack of audio in the last few minutes of the video, and decided to upload it anyway. I'm honestly shocked that we've allowed the quality of these videos to diminish to such an extent that we uploaded a video without any audio in the last few minutes. Could this possibly get any worse? She misspelled Kenya in the hashtags of the video description, and she still hasn't fixed it. She also falsely flagged a video by a YouTuber that has a cartoon character as their avatar, and it ended up getting age restricted. How do you know that she was behind it? Community guideline strikes are very different from Content ID claims and DMCA strikes. For all we know, one of Blair's crazy and overzealous fans tried to take that video down. His portrayal of her in that video was not kind in the slightest. Not only did he lambast her for how poorly she handled this scandal, he was sympathetic towards Oz, Wonderstruck, The Click, and One Topic, and he metaphorically killed her at the end. I don't think Blair liked that video, and you and I have both known her long enough to know that she is petty and vindictive enough to do something like this. If you think that's bad, I discovered something yesterday that's even worse. Blair created two more alt accounts. The first one falsely accused Wonderstruck of being a member of an organization that advocates for pedophilia simply due to the fact that he is gay. And the second one falsely accused Oz and Wonder of being sexist because they called her out for having a messy house that she never cleans. We also can't forget the fact that she uploaded a video about P.T. Barnum today where she said this.
Disney has been known for romanticizing even the most tragic events, with Pocahontas probably being one of their greatest disservices to a true history. But about 6 years ago, they struck gold again when Disney released The Greatest Showman. It's said to be based on the story of P.T. Barnum, the famous creator of the Barnum and Bailey Circus. In the trailer, Barnum is a down-on-his-luck guy that simply wants to make a difference. He believes he can create a show that celebrates how everyone is special. He sees all of us, even those considered as circus freaks, as human beings, and he wants to show the world how unique his talented performers are. He's going to turn them into stars. But as that Feel Good This Is Me song plays, you might start to realize that Barnum isn't celebrating anything. He's simply exploiting people. Disney might want to gloss over this fact with sparkly costumes and romance plots, but Barnum was ultimately using people. So do you want to know the real story of the first performer Barnum hired? Well, he didn't actually hire her at all. He purchased the right to rent an elderly black woman, a slave, when he was just 25 years old. Barnum's acquaintance had apparently been trumpeting this woman, Joyce Heth, around Philadelphia, claiming she was the 161-year-old nurse of George Washington. Why Barnum was so interested in her? To give her a better life and show the world how special she was? Absolutely the f*** not.
Alexa, which studio made The Greatest Showman?
According to an Alexa Answers contributor, The Greatest Showman was released by 20th Century Fox.
Speaking of Blair, where is she? I haven't seen her all day. She went over to Oz's house to talk about some very important stuff. Oh no, she's not gonna do what I think she's going to do, right? You're foreclosing my house? How in the hell is that even possible? You don't even own it. Remember that little deal I had you sign last December? If you fell behind the monthly payments you owed me at any time, I had the right to foreclose your house. I've had that option since June, and now I'm finally exercising that option. You had the right to foreclose my house this entire time and you didn't tell me? I know we broke up, but we dated for 3 years. We were not only best friends, we were partners. I stood behind you when The Click, Wonderstruck, and One Topic all gave up on you, and I tolerated all of the harassment you levied against them with your alt accounts, and this is the thanks that I get? Why are you doing this to me? You can hardly be surprised, Oz. I was 28 and had a lot of bad credit, and you were 20 and had good credit. I saw you as someone I could easily manipulate because you would be eager to listen to someone that was older and more experienced when it came to finances. Why else do you think I pushed all of my bad credit onto you? You knew that I was destined to fall behind on the debt that I owed you, and when I did, you would take away the house that I bought. The only reason I signed that contract is because I didn't want you to go to jail, and I also wanted to save our relationship. If I had known you were planning something like this, I never would have signed it. There's no need to get upset, Oz. It's nothing personal. It's just business. That's bullshit, Blair, and you know it. It's all personal. I had to create a GoFundMe page to help pay for my legal fees because I didn't have the money, and you temporarily took it down by reporting it. If that isn't personal, then quite frankly, I don't know what is. If you hadn't sided with those slanderous traitors, you wouldn't be in this mess. I wouldn't be in this mess if I didn't meet you. I gave you 3 years of my life. I came to work for you to pay off my debt. I listened to everything that you told me because I trusted you, and I did everything in my power to try and make you happy, and in return, you've refused to let me talk to people you don't like, you've isolated me from my family, you've driven me into financial ruin, and now you're suing me for my house? Don't you dare blame this on the people you used to call friends. I heard you were making a big expose video about me. It would be a shame if something happened to it. I still plan on releasing that video, and nothing you say or do will change that. I'm done letting you control my life. I didn't start this fight, but I damn sure intend to finish it. I have way more money than you. As a matter of fact, I've made so much money throughout my YouTube career that I can retire and live comfortably for the rest of my life. You, on the other hand, are in the deep end of the pool without a safety net. Even with your GoFundMe money, you're not going to be able to keep up with the cost of legal fees in the long run, so you'll be much better off if you don't make that video on me. Because if you do, I will continue to make your life very difficult. But if you decide not to, I will drop all of the legal claims against you. You know what I want, Mr. Christie, so be a good boy and do the right thing. Don't make me destroy you. The only thing that will stop this video from coming out is a bullet going through me. I didn't want to have to do this, but you've given me no choice. Santa baby, your house is getting foreclosed by Christmas, and there's nothing you can do about it. The Golden Queen has ruined your life. Santa baby, I hope you enjoy being homeless. It didn't have to be this way. There's no one to blame for this mess but yourself. No one's coming down the chimney tonight. Have a nice life, Mr. Christie. This is a moment I've been waiting for a very long time. I'm proud to introduce the newest member of the YouTube Hall of Shame, Blair Christie, aka Illuminati. It is a hugely humiliating dishonor to be inducted into the YouTube Hall of Shame. You're probably expecting me to do what I've done for the last 10 years and blame everybody else for my downfall, but the reality is that my fall from grace was a mess entirely of my own making, and I have nobody to blame but myself. With all that being said, some apologies are in order. Azothan, I deeply regret the way I treated you. We had something special, and I failed to recognize that. I was so obsessed with attacking Slash because I believed that he was subbotting that I lost sight of what was important, and that was you. I loved you with all of my heart, and I should have made more of an effort to prove that to you by my actions and not my words. I shouldn't have plotted to send you on a plane ride back home if you didn't reciprocate my love in Las Vegas, and I shouldn't have used your suicidal thoughts to hurt you when we were fighting. You're not mediocre and you're not a burden, and my biggest mistake was not realizing that sooner. Tommy C, I'm sorry I deleted all of the videos that I was featured in on your channel. While I was eager to move on and advance my career, I should have done so in a more professional manner. Even though you made a fat joke at someone else's expense, those videos were not mine to delete, and I'm deeply ashamed that I screwed you over like that and ruined what was otherwise a pretty good friendship. Team Pyramid, I'm sorry that my selfishness and narcissism cost you all your jobs. I was so focused on trying to destroy my detractors that I failed to realize the potential consequences of my actions. My foolish tweet on April 20th, 2023 was the catalyst for my downfall, and the fact that you all lost your jobs because I was exposed for the horrendous things I did behind the scenes just a few years earlier horrifies me to this very day. I was a terrible boss and a terrible leader, and you all deserved so much better. If I hadn't gone after Legal Eagle, none of what transpired afterwards would have ever happened, and you all would still have jobs. I am deeply ashamed and embarrassed that I put you all in that position, and I hope that one day you can all find a way to forgive me. Madison, I'm sorry that I bullied and harassed you when you were pregnant. I was jealous and insecure about the fact that there was another anti-MLM channel on YouTube, and I took out that frustration on you. You didn't deserve the awful treatment I levied against you, especially when it was over something so petty. I know words can't make up for all of the hell I put you through, but I want you to know that I am genuinely sorry, and I hope that you can find it in your heart to forgive me one day. And finally, to all of Sad Milk, Oz Media, Wonderstruck, The Click, and One Topic. Words can truly not express how sorry I am for how things turned out between us. To say that my treatment of you all was despicable would be an understatement. I lashed out because I believed that I could get away with it. Obviously, that turned out to be false. The bullying, harassment, stalking, airing out dirty laundry, and everything in between are things that I willingly chose to do because my narcissistic ego had grown way too big. And due to my inability to move on from friendships and relationships that have run their course, I self-destruct and go out of my way to ruin the lives of the people I once considered friends and significant others. The worst part about all of this is the fact that I can't take it back. None of this was your fault. After many years of soul-searching, I have come to the realization that I was the problem, and that I was simply too selfish and egotistical to admit it. You don't have to accept my apology, and you all have the right to hate me until the day you die, but I just want you to know that I am genuinely sorry about everything I did to you, and that I am taking the first steps towards becoming a better person, and that is not performative grifting. I wonder if she knows that I used an artificial crowd machine to make her believe that people actually showed up to watch this performative act that she calls an apology.